channel. So as y'all read from the title, today's video, I'm going to be giving y'all a 3-month update on this full lace wig that I've been wearing from Na Beauty Hair. So if y'all are interested in finding out how I truly feel about this wig, the price, the details, then keep watching. Okay, y'all, so I'm gonna just start off by saying that this is not a sponsored video. I feel like you have to say that nowadays because people just feel like you can't come on here and give your honest opinion. But honey, I paid every single dime out of my pocket for this wig, okay? So therefore, y'all gonna get my real opinion, okay? So now that we're done with that, let's just go ahead and jump into some details about the wig. And then once we're done with that, I'm gonna give my overall opinion and let y'all know if you need to go run out and buy it or if you can pass. Okay, so this is a full lace Peruvian straight wig. So the texture is Peruvian straight and this is a full lace wig. So what that means is that there is literally lace around the entire wig from front to back. I can pull this up into a ponytail. I can part it all the way down the center. I can do a lot of different things with this wig, which is why I wanted. This is a 150% density wig in 14 inches, and I paid $118. Density is 150%, which is normally not enough for me unless it is short hair. If it's longer hair, obviously I would want the density to be a lot more, somewhere in the 200 range. But because I knew I was getting the length that I was getting, I was fine with the density being 150. If you plan on getting this same wig but you want it in like 24, 26, 28, I would definitely recommend getting the density a lot higher because then it's gonna be fuller. But because I was just getting a 14 inch wig, I was perfectly fine with the density being 150%. So it is 14 inches, like I said, and it stops right here. I mean, it does have waves in it right now. So if it was bone straight, it would probably be like right here a little bit. So it is a nice length, and I do feel like it is true to length. And I do need to point this out that the lace was transparent. So the difference between transparent lace and any other lace is this lace was white, like it was stark white. And I was not really a fan of that when I first got the wig, but it ended up being perfect because I used a tint spray and it literally went from white to like the perfect tone. I feel like the quality of the lace was pretty good. It tinted the way that I wanted it to, and you can no longer see the white. I've washed this wig at least 4 or 5 times now, and it does not get back to white. The quality of the hair is very, very soft. Like if you guys see it, it has like a lot of bounce to it. It has a lot of movement to it. I'm trying not to mess up my hair, but it's very, very soft. I don't have any tangles, any shedding, nothing like that. Normally, if I get any tangling, it'll definitely be at the back of my neck, you know, in the kitchen, but I don't have that issue. And I actually have a few other wigs that I actually have that issue with. And this one, I haven't had that issue at all. I mean, granted, I do really take care of my hair. I mean, I comb through my hair periodically throughout the day. I don't lay on my hair. I wrap it up. 3 months now, I've been wearing the wig on and off, and I've done plenty of styles, from wearing it to the side, wearing it down the middle. I've worn it bone straight. I've worn it curly. I've done plenty of things to this hair at this point, and so far, I haven't had any issues with it. The texture bounces right back. The curls, for the most part, they stay in there. They'll sometimes fall, you know, they'll sometimes fall, but the curls do really hold. I don't use any type of holding spray or anything whenever I curl my hair, and that's just because I don't like for my hair to get sticky, or like I don't like that feeling when it has like a lot of product in it. So I don't use a lot of product on my hair for the most part. I love how silky and straight the hair is. I also love that if I want to throw some waves in it, I can do that and I don't have to worry about it just going back straight. It can actually hold a curl without me having to put anything in it. I don't feel like $118 is a lot of money at all for a wig. I feel like, especially if it's full lace and if the quality of the wig is good, then I feel like that's a steal. So, do I feel like you need to go out and run and get this wig? Yes, I do. Even if you don't get a 14 inch and it isn't $120, I really do feel like whatever you pay for, it will be actually worth it. It came really quickly despite being in the midst of a pandemic. I believe I ordered it on a Friday night and it came that next Tuesday or Wednesday. It was really, really quick. And it's funny because I thought the shipping was gonna be a little bit longer because of everything going on with COVID. But y'all, that wasn't the case at all. The shipping was still good. So do not think that just because we're in the middle of this pandemic that that's gonna play a part, because it really don't. So if you are looking for a nice little inexpensive wig, if you're not trying to spend too much money, but you want the look, then I would definitely recommend you go out and get this wig. Cause y'all, I am not kidding. It is amazing. And I've just been in love with it ever since I got it. So yeah, go out and get this wig, y'all, because you will not be disappointed, I promise you. Now, for this video, I decided I just wanted to keep it simple, so I just threw some waves in there. But if y'all wanna see how I've actually styled this wig since I've gotten it, I will have all three of those videos linked in my description bar, because I actually have three separate videos where I've styled this same wig three different ways. So if y'all wanna see the different styles that you can do with this short wig, then go ahead and watch those videos down below. And that's really the reason why I chose a 14 inch, because when I was going to get the wig, I knew that there were certain looks that I had in mind. So that's why I just kept it short, because it just worked well with all of the looks that I wanted to do. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Make sure you turn on your post notifications. And as always, I really appreciate y'all for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.